doesn't look so sad now. It's time. Big old mega getting some work done to her today. Really, really top of the line video for you guys today. We are building the ultimate daily driver. It's officially begun, boys. We have parts that just came in. We obviously have the 24x12s that we showed you in the last video. We have a leveling kit on the way. Now, as you're as I'm filming this, I haven't ordered the leveling kit yet because I don't know what I want yet, quite yet. But we are taking this over to my brother's. He has got a top of the line tune and delete kit for this truck. We're gonna go over there and we're gonna go through everything and we're gonna get this thing dialed in. Bought it at the very end of January in 2022, and it is almost the very end of January in 2023. I have managed to keep a vehicle stock for almost a year, almost. We're gonna get this thing all tuned up for the big show of Motorama. Now, initially this truck, the plans were to have it in Motorama. Unfortunately, due to only being like a month left before the show, it's not gonna happen because it's still stock. I was planning on doing like 3 years worth of work in 3 months, and it's just not possible.
All right, we haven't driven this thing in about 3 months. Let's see what kind of codes pop up on the screen here. Batteries are a little weak. Air pressure's low. Coolant's low. Anything else? Oh, perform service. Oh, and windshield wiper. Ugh. She's a little rough today, boys.
We're at my brother's. We're going to go check out the parts that we got for the little mega there. End up pulling the truck around back here. Got 5-inch stainless exhaust for it. I'm sitting back here along with an Easy Link tuner. We're just waiting on the tunes right now, but come on in. We got 2007 blue Patriot blue mic pad here. We'll do a video on this truck eventually. It's all torn apart right now. It should be the exhaust. We'll go ahead and open it up here. Gold Laramie. Little stainless 5-inch.
Like it's nothing.
Nice hangers, nice welds. There's no branding label to it, but it looks pretty good. Very legal exhaust system that anyone can put on any truck.
A big elbow.
Yeah, that's way bigger than that. Oh yeah. Turbo. Little band clamp flange action. Oh, it's really nice actually. And we got the clamps. All right, okay. These little packages that we got. I'm assuming this is the tuning dial or switch, whatever you want to call it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Gonna be on 5 100% of the time. Rest in peace to my transmission. And I believe this is the EGR delete kit. Life would be a lot easier with a razor blade right about now. You know we're going full send when we're ripping the packaging. I'm not gonna take all this stuff out, but you guys get the idea here. This is the EGR delete kit. If you don't know what it is, go ahead and look it up. We don't do part numbers around here, so figure it out yourself. I'll bring the truck around back here, and we're gonna leave it here for the foreseeable future until probably next Friday. Here's all the parts. My brother's gonna do a very nice time lapse for you people and show him putting all this stuff on. Like I said, this is all stainless. You can see the welds, hangers, everything looks actually really nice. My black truck has a MBRP 5-inch exhaust on it. And like, I don't know what brand this is, but I can tell you what, this is definitely better quality than the MBRP was. If I ever need to down the line, I can have the panels to be near finished. So I'm really excited about that.
I believe it's a 2013 Mega Cab Cummins. Wants me to do a time lapse on the whole deal, but I figured for anyone that doesn't know how to do this already, I kind of thought to myself that we do a little tutorial, a of how to do it. The flange that comes up from here to put the plastic surrounding cover on, that piece right there. They're just 2 8-millimeter bolts just to clean it up, because I mean, this crossover pipe will be gone. EGR valve, cooler, everything will be gone. You'll have your black off plates, your block off plates on the manifold itself. Once that's all done, you can go ahead and put your 8 8-millimeter bolts back down on the valve, the upper valve cover itself. We got the intake block off plate on. We're pulling the EGR cooler itself. It's got 6 fasteners holding it down. You got 2 15-millimeter nuts on the back side of that cooler. I would soak these in some sort of penetrating oil, because they can be a mess if you break one off, because there's studs coming up. They're not bolts. 4 bolts up on the cooler itself over these bands. You just plug it away. About ready to pull this cooler out. I lied. You do have to pull your upper valve cover here on these newer trucks, because it's got a little sensor that goes right by your crankcase vent. EGR cooler out. I gotta pull that big ugly bracket out of there still, but our EGR valve off, got a crossover pipe out, and we got our intake blocked off, like I already mentioned. It's been a while since I had some parts fall off one of these newer Dodges, and totally forgot the intercooler is tucked up underneath the radiator like that. Most Dodges I've ever worked on, cooling system wise, you have your petcock on the bottom of the radiator itself over on this side. You put a bucket up underneath here and just open that petcock and let it drain. There is a little petcock right there, but it's got a little pipe coming out of the bottom of it. And I thought to myself, I'm like, well, that's gonna be a hell of a lot easier to get to than pulling all that stuff. So just rigged myself up a little hose with a 90 on it, fit that up on that nipple, ran a hose to a bucket, got, I would say, like 4 gallons of coolant out. You wanna get as much coolant out as you can, say 3 gallons, probably the minimum, is what I usually go off of. So this, when you pull your EGR cooler, you don't have coolant flying everywhere, and all these, you know, standpipes and crossover pipes aren't blowing coolant. I mean, you'll still leak a little bit, but. Just a disclaimer, all these parts that I'm taking off are going back on. All right, boys, it's a couple days later since we dropped the truck off. We're over here at my brother's. Go inside and check out my truck. I've been waiting a long time for it to be deleted like this. Doesn't look any different. A lot of crap inside the bed. Like I said, all this stuff is off of another truck. It's not off of this truck. This truck still has everything legalized on it. Everything back onto the truck. It just sounds weird right now. But anyway, everything is good to go. We're gonna get it started up. See what it sounds like, because I've been waiting a long time to hear what this thing sounds like, the spicy tune on. So. Sounds good. Read anything? Everything but the exhaust system? Yeah. Like I said, we didn't do anything crazy on it. Just delete and stay with the dog. First official test drive, tuned and deleted at 69,000 miles. We got the stage 1 through 5 down there. Successful first drive in the newly tuned and deleted 13 Mega. We have officially unlocked tow mirror mode. That's right, everyone. It's another tuned and deleted truck. That only means one thing. That means we can put up the tow mirrors without any criticism whatsoever. Looks, sounds way better. Now don't get me wrong, this ain't no race truck, okay? Maybe in some people's eyes. So we got all this stuff in the back of the truck. We got all the exhaust that came off of it originally. We're gonna unload that, and we are going to, like, we literally just got back this thing and we're already putting it to use. We're gonna take it up to
Owego and drop off my specialty forged rims that I showed you guys in a previous video. And we're gonna get the wheels and tires mounted, or rims and tires mounted. Hopefully, we'll bring them back and we'll throw them on tonight. Maybe. I was thinking about doing some cosmetic stuff to it, but I'm like, we can't do any cosmetic stuff to it until it is the OG tuned and deleted, if you know what I mean. Boys, we got a special surprise. We got the rims and tires mounted. We got the red truck back yesterday from getting tuned and deleted. We are good to mount the rims and tires. Take both of these trucks up to the big garage, see kind of what we need for our leveling kit and bumper spacers and trimming if we need anything.
Drinking dope, turn me to a superhero, yeah. Hit that pill, turn me to a superhero, yeah. Roll my 90s, turn me to a superhero, yeah.
Metro, in your Metro, don't trust you, I'm gonna shoot you.
I'm in that dope again, I'm in that flow again, switch up the flow again, yeah, yeah. Fly down the parachute, gripping that pole again, I'm on that all again, yeah, yeah. Candy in the cup, gotta get paid. King in the streets, young nigga made. Spreading on the crowd, take it to the grave. Ain't having problems, I'm sipping the bar. Shout out to Dallas, my bitch is a star. Nigga get rich, ready to take you to war. Piss on your casket, shoot at your bra. Do you something nasty, roll you in a gun. Bitch get graphic, fuck me in a car. I get your brand new roller tomorrow. I put that brand new roll on your arm. Ain't moving slow, but I'm still on R. Tennis braces and they came with the frost. Cuba links all the way up to your jaw. Step up the swag when I step on a bra. $2.50, ooh, that's the cheapest one. Stacking these oranges up like coupons. Told you from up again, upper echelon. I get the stacking up, I'm untouchable. I get to represent money multiple. I'm at the top of the charts, unapproachable. Bread by the loaf.
Alright, so about a day and a half later, we have the truck sitting right where we want. We have the rear end dropped about an inch and a quarter. We took out the leaf spring extra plates that they come from the factory with. So we dropped the rear, like I said, an inch and a quarter, and it looks pretty solid back here. And then up front, we have two jacks up here. Since we don't have the leveling kit installed yet, we have two jacks to mimic a 1.5 inch leveling puck. So right as you see it, it looks pretty leveled right now. So after we get that inch and a half leveling puck in it, it's almost exactly how it should sit after an inch and a half leveling puck. Whole goal of this truck is a ultimate daily driver, so I think we're getting there step by step pretty surely. Well, there you have it, guys. 24 by 12 specialties with floaters and a tune and delete all done within under a week. The truck is running mint. She's got plenty of power now. Right now we're taking her back home because she is going to get tint right now, actually. By the time you guys see this truck, she'll have 20% in the front and 35% on the shield. Surprisingly, even with the reverse level and no lift in the front, these 24 by 12s actually clear for the most part pretty good. If you know anything about turning races, and if you're good with it, I get about a turn and a quarter on the steering wheel before anything even starts to rub on here. This is how the truck sits here in about 30 minutes. She's going up about 45 minutes away to get some tint done. We're gonna be doing 20% on the front windows, and we are going to be doing 35% on the shield. This is gonna be 20% because I do still like to see every single day. Black truck has 5/20, which is extremely dark, and let's be realistic, maybe for you, other people have different preferences, but I daily driving this thing with the cops and stuff like that, I'd like to be able to see out the windows and still pass a cop test or whatever the window thing. This thing's gonna be sent away. I'm gonna cut right now to after it's done and give you guys a full walk around and do a little edit for you guys. And as you can tell, just because there are 12 wides does not mean that the truck does not get dirty. It is the next day. We have her back. She is done with tint. We have, like I said, we have 35 on the front windshield and 20% matching all the way around to pretty much match the factory tint that comes from the factory. And let's give you a little overview. What have we done in this video? We have tuned and deleted with EFI Live tuning for a 2013 Ram 2500 Cummins diesel. Handle 420Vs I'm not sure what the specs are on these. They're 424, or they're 305, 35, R24. So there you go on that. The specs for the wheels, 24 by 12 specialty forged. SF, I still don't know the model number. But that's what they are. I don't know why I'm walking over here. There's nothing to show you over there. They have a reverse level. We took out the factory blocks, or the factory spacing blocks, in the leaf pack. And that's how you have it. We still need to do the leveling puck up front. That is coming shortly. Anyway, it just started snowing. Literally, as I'm talking. LB, that's pretty much it. You guys want to see a burnout? I want to see how well this thing does a burnout on these new tires. Well, I wonder if they smoke.
Shop, that's a total. Fill up the garage, bitch, I'm a mogul. Ain't no facade, ain't no fugazi. I jump it off, I get paid. Drop top rust, I'm going crazy. I push off, smoking on haze. Not trying to floss, Cartier shades. Candy in the cup, gotta get paid. King in the streets, young nigga made. Spreading on the crowd, take it to the grave. Ain't having problems, I'm sipping the bar. Shout out to Dallas, my bitch is a star. Nigga get rich, better take it to war. Piss on your casket, shoot at your bra. Do you something